Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. So in today's video I am going to discuss about relational operator, then logical operator and assignment operator. Okay, so in my previous session I have started the topic of operators in C, and there I have discussed about what is operator, then the types of operator and the arithmetic operator. And today I am going to discuss about relational, logical and assignment. Okay, so let's start. So see here, this is the relational operator. Okay, so relational operators are used to compare two expressions. Okay, so it is always used for comparing the expressions. The result of the relational operator or means operation is a boolean value. Boolean means this should be true or false, and true means 1 and the false is represented as 0. When the result will be true, this will be 1, and when the result is false, this will be represented as 0. Okay, so this is called as boolean value, and the result of this relational operator is always the boolean value. Okay, example of relational operator is equal, not equal to, then greater than, less than, greater than equal to, less than equal to. So these are the operators which are always used for comparing the expressions. Okay, say for example 8 equal to 5. Okay, so this is different from the equal sign. Okay, I will discuss it in my later slides, what is the difference between equal to and this double equal to. Okay, this is double equal to. Okay, so this double equal to means this is a relational operator. Okay, here it will compare whether the value of these two is equal or not. Here see 8. 8 is compared to 5. Means 8 is equal to 5. No. Okay. So it will comparing whether these two value is equal or not. So here 8 is not equal to 5. That's why the result is 0. Means the expression is false. Okay. Next one see 6 less than 6 greater than 5. Means 6 greater than 5. Here the expression is true. That's why here the result is 1. Next one is 5 not equal to 3. This expression is also true because 5 is not equal to 3. So therefore the result is 1, means true. So equal to means this double equal to, and means not operator, not equal to operator are called as equality operators. Means this double equal to means equal, double equal to and not equal to, okay, are called as equality operators because it will always compare whether your expressions are equal or not. It will compare whether your expressions are equal or not. Here also it will compare your expression will be equal or not equal. Okay, that's why it is called as equality operators. Next one is logical operators. Okay, so C language supports the three logical operator mainly. This one is and, okay, this one is or, and this operator is called as not. Okay, so they are used with one or more relational expressions and the result is true or false. Okay, these operators are used with one or more relational expressions, and here also the result is true or false, means 0 or 1. Okay, so first one is AND. So AND is a binary operator. It records two operands. Means always AND operator use two operands. That's why it is called as binary operator. The result of this operation is true if both its operands are true and false otherwise. Means if both the operands are true, then the result will be true. Otherwise, if one of them is false, then result will be false. And if both are the false, then result will definitely false. Okay, so see the example. 5 equal to 5 means it will compare whether your this 5 is equal to this 5 or not. Okay, so this expression is true. Okay, and 4 greater than 6, this expression is false. Okay, so in case of AND operator, if both the expression is true, then only result is true. But here this expression is false, but this expression is true. Okay, but still the result will false. That's why here the result is 0. Here also 5 greater than 3, this expression is true. And here see 4 not equal to 5. Okay, so this true and this true, 4 not equal to 5, this also true. So true and true means true. So result will be 1 because the result is true. Okay, next one is OR. Okay, so OR is also a binary operator because it use two operands. So the these operations result true if either of one of its two operands is true. It result false only when both operands are false. Means in case of OR operator, means OR operations, if both the operations means expression is true, then result is true. If one of them is true, then also result is true. It will give the result false if both the expression is false. Okay, see the example. This one is true, this one is what? False, because 3 greater than 5, this one is false, but here this expression is true, that's why result is true, means 1. But in case of this 5 greater than 10, this one is false, and 3 equal to 5, this one is also false. The false or false means false, therefore result is 0. And last one is NOT operator. It is a unary operator. It has only one operand on the right hand side. So it use only one operand on the right hand side only. That's why it is called as unary operator. It gives the result true if the operand is false, and if the operand is true, then it will give the result is false. Means it will give the opposite result. Okay. Say, see this one the example. This one is represented as one operand. Okay. 6 greater than 2. This one is true, but not true means false. Therefore, result is 0. Here also see, this one is true, this one is false. But in case of OR operator, true or false means true. Okay, but not true means false. So it will give you the result 0. Okay, clear? If you have any doubt, then please comment me on the comment section. Okay, so next one is assignment operator. So this operator is used to assign a value to a variable. Okay, means this one is assign a value to a variable. We see here a equal to 5 means here 5 is a value, a is a variable, where 5 is assigned to the variable a. Okay, so this one is called as assignment operator. So I have already discussed about the double equal to. Here see single equal. So this equal to and that equal is different. I will show you the difference in the later part. Okay, so see here, this operation follows the right to the left rule. Okay, right to the left rule means here right means the value 5, and it will assign to the value means variable a. That's why it will follow the rule right to the left, means right hand side value will assign to the left hand side variable. That's why it is follow the rule right to left. The value at the right hand side of the assignment operator is assigned to the variable on the left of the operator. Okay, that's why it is right to left. Next one is left of the assignment operator is called as L value, and right side is called as R value. Means this side is called as L value and this side is called as R value. So see the example here. A equal to 2 plus B equal to 10. Here another assignment operator is used in the right hand side, where we have used here the value. Here this operator means this assignment operator is used as a value of this main assignment operator. Okay, so see here B equal to 10 means the value. Here the value 10 is assigned to the variable b. So the value of b is 10. So 10 plus 2 means 12. That's why a equal to 12. Okay. Now see the difference between these two operators. Okay. So the first one is an assignment operator. Okay. Where it will be used for assign the value to the means variable of the left hand side. Okay, but this sign means this operator is equality operator. Okay, because it compares the two expression on the either side whether it is equal to each other or not. Okay, so see the example. A equal to 5. Here this one is assignment operator where 5 is assigned to the left hand side a variable A. Okay, here it will assign the value. Here the 5 is stored to the variable A. But in case of this one is an equality operator where it will compare the two values of the left hand side and the right hand side, whether the value of left hand side is equal to right hand side or not. Okay, so this is the difference between these two operator. So this is all about today's class. So if you have any doubt, then please comment me on the comment section. Okay, and if you like my video, then please share my video and subscribe my channel if you are new to my channel. Thank you all.